Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video guys, we'll be working on a Mazda. So if you have any Mazda vehicle guys, such as Mazda 2, 3, 5, 6, let's say you have Mazda CX-7, CX-3, CX-5 guys, and the car does not want to start guys, okay, does not crank, does not start, you just turn the ignition key on and nothing happens, we'll explain guys what could be the reason for that, the most common reason. So stay with us guys and we'll explain today. In addition guys, quick introduction, we'll have more than 200 videos on every car we get at the shop because our mission is to save you guys as much money as we can. So please subscribe to the channel, like the video, leave a comment below, let us know if the video was helpful and if it helped you fix your problem. So let's start on it now. So I'm going to go inside and demonstrate how it doesn't start now guys. Okay, no matter what we do, you just turn the key on and nothing happens. So nothing guys, let's go ahead and explain you what you need to check now. So we need to open the hood of your Mazda vehicle guys, and usually somewhere by the battery guys, by the car battery, there is a fuse box. Okay, that fuse box, as you know, if you worked on Ford and Mazda, they have quite a bit in common, they share many components. Like this one, it even says that Ford Motor Company on the thing sometimes guys, it's crazy. And you open the fuse box cover. And what you need to check now, you don't need to worry about fuel pumps or anything like that. Why? Because the car doesn't want to crank. So it's something that blocks the signal being sent to the starter, or it's starter related now guys. Now, reason number one, check the fuse guys for the starters. Okay, you often have fuse for the starter and you often guys have relays, one or two relays for the starter. In our case guys, check out on the cover now right here. Okay, it says starter number 2 relay and starter main relay. Okay, they're right here. Let me show you now. Let's come just a little bit this way. Okay, this is a starter relay and this is a starter relay. We have the video on the channel how to replace them, how to inspect and test them as well. If you want to, you can just switch it with another relay. That's not important. Let's say the starter relay is the same as the one for the heater blower motor fan, so we can temporarily switch them and see if that fixes the problem. But now sometimes on Mazda you will not find a fuse that say starter guys. Okay, it may say engine, it may say okay ignition key, and here we have another ignition key. So far guys we have three fuses that could be related to a starter. And make sure you stay until the end, I'm going to explain something else too. This cover, you might have one of those, and you have those special fuses guys, and one of those, okay, it's for the starter or ignition key. So I'm going to get a voltmeter, okay, and I'm going to test these fuses. If you guys need to find replacement fuses, or you need to get a voltmeter like ours, this is amazing voltmeter, all that will be listed in the description of the video below for your convenience. So if I set it at resistance and I check one end of the fuse to the other one, we should go close to zero, okay, like that. This is a good fuse because it means we have communication from one end of the fuse to the other one. If the fuse is burnt, it will be like we have no connection at all. So this is a good fuse guys. Now we have something else. Okay, we tested our relays, they're perfect. What else it could be? We have a second fuse guys for ignition right here, that says ignition key. So we're going to check that one as well. Perfect, I pull it out and I'm going to test it now and see what the deal is with that fuse. Okay, and what do we got here guys? Okay, zero. Okay, no communication, we should approach zero. If it's a good fuse guys, it should be like this one, remember going to zero, but it's not. So we have a bad fuse that we need to replace. Now if guys all your fuses are good, okay, let me grab the new one quick. Okay, if all your fuses are good, what do you need to check now guys? Okay, you need to check if your starter is good. We have a video how to test it. Also on some Mazdas, okay, you have a fuse guys on the battery cable right here. This is a fuse that is for the starter and the alternator. So if that fuse is bad, okay, your car will not crank as well. And this fuse, you cannot open it. Most of the times you have to test it from here to here or from here to the starter wire to see if there is communication with the voltmeter. Now Let's say all that is good, guys. Your starter, you even removed it, you tested it, it's good. All the fuses are good. What else it could be, guys? It could be a bad, okay, bad immobilizer or a bad key. Sometimes keys go bad, immobilizers go bad, and if the immobilizer is not reading the key, guys, the car will not start and you have the same symptoms. But in our case, that's not the problem. It was just the fuse for the ignition key. And now I'll attempt to go ahead and start the car. So you can see fire dried up. So hopefully, guys, that will be the case with your Mazda. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel for more videos and see you guys next time.